Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson, and this month of camera news for filmmakers is going to be insane. Canon is starting things off with the official announcement of the R5 and R6 full-frame mirrorless cameras, which are, in my opinion, the most exciting cameras Canon has released since the original 5D Mark II in 2008. Yes, it has taken 12 years for Canon to catch my interest again, but here we are. Here's my video roadmap. Today, I want to share with you the video specs for the new Canon R5 and tell you my initial thoughts about this camera from a Sony user's perspective. I've used Sony cameras since 2012, but like I said, the R5 has caught my eye. Tomorrow, you can expect to see a similar video about the Canon R6. But remember, I said this month is a crazy month for new cameras. And later this month, Sony is supposed to be unveiling the successor to the A7S II. The A7S III, A7S IV, whatever the heck they want to call it, it's finally happening. The mythical unicorn is almost here. I also hear that Nikon may be dropping the successors to the Z6 and the Z7. Does anybody actually shoot with Nikon? I know like two people that do. They'll be excited. Wow. This is going to be a crazy month, and I would love if you would consider subscribing if you want to see videos about all these cameras. Moving on, let's talk about the Canon R5. And I want to start by saying this is a camera I never thought Canon would make. Or perhaps more accurately, I didn't think that Canon would make a camera with these video specs until the year 2030. And even then, the camera would be gimped in some way, like a 5-minute recording limit in 8K, or no 24 frames per second recording. Surprising all of us though, Canon chose 2020 to be the year they dropped the R5 with full frame raw 8K video recording in our laps. The first half of 2020 has been pretty terrible, but I think I speak for most filmmakers whenever I say this new camera is a ray of sunshine. But I also never thought that Canon would actually make it. I actually made a video talking about the specs for the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K last year, talking about how that company was willing to give us 6K raw video and a camera with a Canon EF mount. And in that video, I chastised Canon for not being willing to do the same. I have never been happier to be proven wrong before. Canon has taken what Blackmagic did with the BMPCC 6K and cranked it up to 11. Let's start with the resolution. The R5 records in 8K resolution at up to 30 frames per second in full frame with no crop. And when I say 8K resolution, I mean you have the option to either record in 8K DCI, which is 8192 by 4320, or 8K Ultra, which is 7680 by 4320. Also, because this is Canon, I feel like I need to say right off the bat, 24 frames per second recording is included in the camera out of the box. Thank God there doesn't have to be a big outcry about basic things like that. Now you get three choices for video quality with this camera. Canon splits things up into IPB, All-Eye, and RAW video. IPB will be a bit smaller and lower quality. All-Eye is larger with more data per frame of video, and of course RAW is raw video. Both All-Eye and IPB record video in 422 10-bit using the H.265 codec. Please be aware that whenever I say some of these file sizes are smaller than others, this is still 8K video. So it's still gonna be massive. It's a large file size, and RAW takes the cake with a shockingly high data rate of 2600 megabits per second. Yes, 8K RAW video on this camera records over a terabyte per hour. Those of you that record on the 1DX Mark II are suddenly thinking, hey, these file sizes aren't that big actually. This is fine, I can work with this. Let's be real though. How many filmmakers are actually going to be recording in 8K, especially in RAW? It's far more likely that we will see people choosing to record in 4K, which I'm pleased to tell you that this camera also records in. You can record full frame in 4K at up to 120 frames per second. Yes, that includes 60 frames per second as well. This records in 422 10-bit using the H.265 codec. 4K is what I think a lot of filmmakers are going to choose to stick with, but I would be aware that those 4K 120 frames per second files aren't going to be small either. That is a lot of data being thrown at the memory card. Speaking of memory cards, this camera has two card slots. The first card slot is CF Express, which, I don't know if you've checked lately, those aren't exactly cheap. The good news is that the second card slot is a UHS 2 SD card slot, which should hopefully help you save some money because SD cards tend to be a bit cheaper. You should know though that the UHS 2 SD cards are slower at 300 megabytes per second. This is compared to the CF Express cards at 1700 megabytes per second. Because of that, you will not be able to record 8K video in RAW to the SD card, only the CF Express card. Wait a second, Matt. Does that mean what I think it means? Yes. Unfortunately, even though this camera has dual card slots, if you want to record in 8K RAW, it is not going to be able to record a backup recording to the second card. Only single card recording is supported in 8K, regardless of whether you're recording in H.265 or RAW. I have not been able to confirm whether or not the R5 supports dual card recording in 4K or other lower resolutions. There is one other reason that I'm not surprised this camera doesn't support dual card recording in 8K, and that is the other elephant in the room that many people have been talking about. I'm speaking, of course, about overheating. Recording 4K video in a small camera body is hard to do without overheating. I should know, I'm recording this video on a Sony camera. Heat is one of the main reasons that I don't think that Sony has supported recording 4K 60 frames per second video in their cameras. When Panasonic released the S1, S1R, and S1H, all three of those cameras are incapable of filming 4K 60 frames per second video in full frame without a crop. Heck, the S1H has a fan inside of it, and it's still incapable of recording full frame 4K 60 video. Then comes Canon, out of nowhere. You want full frame video? 4K? No, you want 8K. Okay, fine, we'll do 4K video, but not just at 60 frames per second. How about 120? What is going on? Where is this coming from? Are these cameras going to melt as soon as you start recording? Well, no, actually, but Canon does say the R5 has approximately a 20-minute limit before overheating while recording 8K and a 25-minute limit before overheating while recording in 4K 60. They aren't artificially limiting this camera to record 8K video for 5 minutes before stopping to prevent overheating. No, instead Canon is limiting it for a different reason. And yes, that is a segue into one of the main cons for this camera. While it may not have a recording time limit for heat, it does have an overall video recording time limit of 29 minutes and 59 seconds. The blasted tax laws that keep camera companies from offering longer recording times strike again. Unlike Panasonic and even Sony's newer cameras that record longer than 30 minutes, Canon has chosen to slap this camera with a recording time limit, and that is a shame. Let's now talk about something positive about this camera. The R5 and R6 are the first cameras from Canon to support true in-body image stabilization. No gross electronic image stabilization. Look, it's less shaky. Also, it's cropped in a ton. Thankfully, Canon is not doing that, and they are joining Panasonic and Sony with IBIS. So glad they made it. In another surprise, the R5 will also support zebras, those weird wavy lines you can see on your screen to tell you when your shot is overexposed. I use these every time I film with my Sony camera, so it's great to see Canon offer this as a feature for filmmakers. Now let's talk about some things that are a bit less novel, but still good to know. First, the R5 will also support the Canon log picture profile, so I would expect a nice dynamic range from the image. As someone that shoots video in log, I love when cameras include it. Canon has introduced dual pixel autofocus 2 with the R5 and R6 cameras, and of course it is improved. With 100% coverage of the sensor and 819 autofocus points when recording video, Canon's legendary focusing capabilities should be even better. Earlier this year, there was a bit of controversy though, when Canon announced the 1DX Mark III. The messaging about that camera caused confusion about which resolutions would support dual pixel autofocus. I have good news with the R5 though. All frame rates and all resolutions support dual pixel autofocus. You want to shoot a vlog with the flippy screen in 8K resolution? You get dual pixel autofocus. You want to shoot a gross 4K resolution, such low quality, video? dual pixel autofocus is still supported. I can't even handle this resolution. Lastly, there's the battery. I'm pretty sure Canon has set a record for the amount of times they've used the same battery form factor, because the 5R uses the same battery as the EOS R, the 5D Mark IV, the 5D Mark III, the 5D Mark II, the 7D, oh gosh, a ton of cameras. If you've ever filmed with a Canon camera, you probably have a few of these batteries just laying around somewhere. Okay, wrapping up here, let's talk about price. This is a heck of a lot of camera. And up until recently, literally the announcement of the price of this camera, I wouldn't have believed it. Keep in mind, this is Canon. Whenever they released the 5D Mark II and filmmakers loved it, they said, oh, filmmakers love this $2,700 camera? Let's release a $16,000 C300 camera for them. I still remember when I was in college and I saw that price and I immediately said, well, buy Canon. And then Sony was there to greet me with its warm, slightly green tinted skin tone arms to hold me close and comfort me. That's a Sony skin tone joke for you, because there's a Canon video, Canon's known for their colors. Why am I explaining this? My point here is that Canon should have no business releasing an 8K raw shooting camera for $3,900 in 2020. But here we are. I don't know what happened to the old Canon. Canon, who literally at the beginning of 2020 released the 1D X3 for $6,500. Here we are, barely 6 months later, and Canon's releasing a camera with better video quality and specs for thousands of dollars less. Is Canon crazy or is it just me? Leave me a comment down below and let me know who's the crazy one here, because I can't believe that I'm even making this video. Reel it in. Okay, there is one question left that we need to answer in this video. Based on the video specs alone, should you buy this camera? And I feel really weird saying this because it's literally been over a decade since I've recommended somebody buy a Canon camera, but yes, I think you should buy it. I think it's a great camera. If you want a future-proofed option, based on specs alone, this is a fantastic camera. I only have two hangups on why you should wait to buy it. First, if you live in a hotter climate, like me in Texas, then I would definitely recommend waiting until you can see some reviews that address whether this camera overheats. Second, at the same time Canon announced the R5, they also announced the R6, which is arguably many filmmakers' dream camera. If the R5 is more than we ever could have dreamed or imagined, then the R6 is exactly what we wanted. Should you buy the R6 then? Subscribe to my channel, where tomorrow I will be posting a video specs breakdown of the Canon R6. And if you happen to be watching this video later than right after I posted it, please still consider subscribing, but I will also link to the R6 specs breakdown video up in the corner and down in the video description. With that, thank you so much for watching. It would be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video. Also, if you happen to be a wedding filmmaker like me, you probably want to buy a new camera. Well, you might after watching this video. I guarantee what you want to do is book more couples and film more weddings. And to help you out with that, I've created a free guide that's gonna give you some practical steps that you can take right now in your business to book more couples and film more weddings. It's a free gift to you. You can download it at the link down in the video description. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.